Becky Shambaugh. Rebecca Shambaugh is an internationally recognized leadership expert, author, keynote speaker, and host of the Women Rise podcast and radio program. And a lot of our listeners have already heard you on a number of the talk shows that air here on our affiliate stations. As a guest, you're a great guest, but you're an even better host. Becky Shambaugh, welcome. Happy holidays. And I guess now more than ever, and one of the, by the way, one of the descriptions of the podcast suggests that in these challenging times, a renewal of leadership skills is critical. That's more true now than ever.
Well, thank you, John, for inviting me here to just have an opportunity to speak with you and to convey to all those out there that wishing them a very warm, wonderful, safe, and healthy holiday. I think it's been, this is a time for reflection more so than many other years. We've had, in some ways, a great wave, a great ride, particularly in my firm at Shambaugh, but there's been challenges for so many folks, right, too, and kind of resetting and rebooting their professional lives, their personal lives. So I do think it's time for reflection, and myself too personally. And, you know, one of the things that I did do in times of reflection over COVID is I really wanted to create a safe place for people to come and to share and inspire others around their leadership. Folks that are, you know, generating great ideas and perspectives that will help people to navigate through not only those times that we experienced the last couple of years, but now coming out of it. Sort of a new way of bringing excitement, new opportunities, and yeah, a new lens on leadership. And so I've had so much fun meeting so many, a wide range of leaders from all walks of life who have shared their stories, who have talked about their insecurities and how they overcame them, to innovative, impactful ways how they're making a difference in this world, their communities, and their organizations and families. And so we're going to continue that next year. But over that time also, you know, I meet with a lot of CEOs and executives. We work with a lot of companies in that space. And I think here's what we can expect for the following year and years to come. And I do think this, it's a, you may say a new model of leadership, but I think the next generation of leaders, they are coming. They are filling the seats. They are eager. They are energetic. They bring new ideas, but they're young. And so that's with any up and coming leader. But I do think that there is hope for this generation to help reharmonize not just our organizational cultures and, you know, environment, but also in our communities and, you know, sort of, you know, society and how we treat one another. Right. And so this is so, so important. So I decided, you know, one of my cornerstones is I've run this company now for 28 years, Shambaugh Leadership, and founder of the Women's Leadership Institute. I said, you know, it's time for me to really transition a little bit and look at my model of how I can start to give back. And so I created a nonprofit called Young Women Rise, which really helps to bring up the next generation of leaders who are women. Not that men aren't important. And I think because as women rise, men will rise as well. That's how I look at this. And so we began to do our research initiative and we'll be continuing that throughout the next several months. And from there, we'll develop a program experience for young women who are from 0 to 5 to 15 years, particularly in the areas of STEM, who are really experiencing some challenging times. And I will say I've sat in on some of the focus groups and seen some of the survey work we've done so far with hundreds of women so far in this particular space. They are eager, they're curious, they are smart, and there's not a deficit in their bone. They want to be in computer science, in engineering, in environmental studies, and biometrics, because they want to make a difference in this world. They want to have an impact and make something better. And so that just reinforced to me purposely, this is where I'm going to be spending a bit of my time in the years to come. You know, I've created a board where we're booting up this initiative, which I'm very excited about, and getting a lot of institutions and companies and women involved in it. So I think, to me, that's, I just want to send that signal out that I think it's time for us to look in and find out in some small way, what can we do to give back? If we had the great fortune of being able to achieve things, to achieve, really map out and realize success for ourselves, no matter what that is, whether it's being a wonderful, wonderful mother to, you know, leader, executive, or, you know, involved in leading the community, what is it that we can do to start giving back, but something that we feel a sense of purpose with? and it know is important and a priority. And I think what I found, and people who are involved in this initiative that I'm in, coming out of COVID, they were looking for something that was purposeful. They were looking for something to have a positive impact. They just didn't know where to start or how to do it. So I'm happy to bring this initiative to so many people that are sort of being drawn to this effort. And I'm eager to share with you next year some of our research, our white papers, and to actually talk about this on the Women Rise podcast and bring some of these young women in to hear their story and how they are channeling their leadership, right, to best serve those that they are working with and of service.
First off, I love the term reharmonize. Second, as a daughter, dad, my ears perk up when I hear things like this. If people are listening now, and obviously subscribing to the podcast is the first and most important thing that you want to do so you can stay up to date. But if they want to get involved in this initiative, how do they do that?
Well, they'll just reach out to www.shambaughleadership.com and say, I'd like to learn more about Young Women Rise. And we would love to hear from them and, you know, see how they might want to get involved. And there's many, many different ways to do that. So we have all arms open to folks that want to participate in our survey and our focus groups, organizations that would like to explore further around the demographics of their women in STEM. Maybe they want to attend our summit next year and be a part of that conversation. So there's just lots of things that we can have them get involved with. So thank you, John.
So again, from affiliate radio stations throughout New England and the middle part of the country to YouTube, which is worldwide. Becky Shambaugh, the floor is yours. Wish everyone a happy and prosperous New Year.
Happy New Year. Merry Christmas.
And don't forget, you have to pick a song on the way out. What is Becky Shambaugh's favorite holiday tune?
Jingle Bells.
You're the first one to pick it, so that you move right to the top of the list. Becky, Happy New Year, Happy Holidays, and I'm so excited to be working with you in 2023.
B-E-L-L-S, I love those J-I-N-G-L-E bells. Oh.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh, dashing through the snow in a one-horse open sleigh.
Good day.